Unhappiness that arises out of comparison. Part 2.
They had to change the tape for recording, so we had to pause. If someone else were to tell me, "Don't say anything," then everyone would feel upset. Why are you stopping him? What is your objection if he speaks? And if these people stop, then it's fine, because the tape for recording needs to be changed. So if someone is stopping us, we can set that Vyavasthita has given us a break in between. There will be a rest break, and then let's see what comes in Vyavasthita. Then there will be no unhappiness. But he did it. Why did he stop us? Get him out of here. There shouldn't be any interference here. We can do whatever we want in satsang. You shouldn't tell us anything. It could be the same incident, but how we take it. When you step out of the airport, there are three or four types of billboards put up there, aren't there? From one view, you can see this. From another view, you can see it like this. This would be considered beauty. This would be... They have such things written there, don't they? They are of three different types. When you come out of the gate at the airport, there is some kind of comparison shown there. It's usually of one thing. There would be a fruit hanging. It can be used for hunger, for beautification, and naturally it is like this. There are three points written there, but it depends from what viewpoint you see it. That is what is mentioned here. Observe and analyze them the next time. But will a person focus on getting home, having his luggage in place, or observing all of this beauty in billboards? But I saw those billboards. I was happy. I thought, this is just a viewpoint. The wrong viewpoint gives unhappiness. And if you set the right viewpoint, then the same thing gives happiness. The viewpoint needs to be changed. The work comes to us on the basis of Vyavasthit, not on the basis of someone giving it to us. So if our viewpoint changes, then that same situation won't cause unhappiness to us. And if someone changes it for us, if someone just says, "What you have is fine, it is all right," and so on, then we become happy again. So, we ourselves, if we feel better by someone making us understand, then why don't we ourselves set the understanding from within as to why did this happen? And that is how Dada would set it. He would feel that this worry arose. There was a loss of 10,000 rupees in our business, so worries began. Then at night, contemplation began within. Whose loss is it? How many people have suffered the loss? Every person at home would say, "I lost 10,000 rupees in the business." The second person would also say that 10,000 has been lost. The partner would also say that 10,000 has been lost. Their children would say that 10,000 has been lost. Now, actually 10,000 has been lost, but 20 people are saying 10,000. So, how much has truly been lost? Divide the 10,000 into 20 parts. Then how much would be our share? So, that is how much we should worry. There's no need to worry about the whole share. And in this way, he peacefully went to sleep. So with such comparison, he found the art of becoming happy. Back then, he also had an intellect, but it was used in a positive manner. He didn't use it in a negative manner. He would find the positive way. How much can be considered as the share of each person in this debt of 10,000? Our share would be 500. So we need to worry only for the 500, not for the rest of the 9,500. So like that, by taking it in a positive manner, whereas we have both positive and negative. What is intellect? Good and bad, high and low, mine and yours, that is all the work of the intellect. And we have jnana with us. It is a circumstance, it is in the form of a file, and we have to finish our karma by finishing these karmic accounts. So if we keep solving this by jnana, then the same situation will not be a source of unhappiness for us. If we are driving a car on the highway and another car comes next to us, then comparison will happen. I went ahead of him. And if he moves ahead, we drive faster and overtake him. But there are millions of cars which have gone ahead of this car. So who should we compare with? And there are millions behind us. Aren't we ahead of them? But the comparison happens with the one next to us. Now, the ones doing seva, there would be comparison in that group of sevartis. Similarly, the ones in the same business would compare. Now, if there was another person doing satsang, then one would compare the two of them. When Niruma and I would do satsangs, I would tell people from the beginning, "Watch out, I am already telling you, don't compare. This is the supply from Dada's tank, whether it comes from the red pipe or the blue pipe, whether it is from Niruma or Deepak Bhai, it is Dada's Nyan. Do not compare. And don't come to me for confirmation after asking her, and don't go to her after asking me. Go by Dada's Nyan. But by comparing with people at the same level, comparison begins. And what about comparison with Dada? No, he is way ahead, beyond our reach. Where does this happen with you all? There are two centers in California. So the comparison would happen between the two centers. What have they done? What should we do? What about Adalaj India? Oh no, leave that. They are far bigger. We are much smaller in comparison, so they wouldn't compare there. What we should do is, we should set things as per our capacity and as per what is suitable for everyone. Whatever they feel suitable, they can go with. It is not worth comparing. And if that comparison happens, then we should be able to immediately recognize our intellect. Hey, stop there. Why are you creating turmoil? Whatever is there in Vyavasthit, theirs is organized based on their circumstances, and ours is organized based on our circumstances. If we turn our intellect around, then unhappiness does not remain. And that is what we want to bring about. In every situation where unhappiness arises due to comparison, we want to turn it around. Why did this happen? It is Vyavasthit. How? It is based on our karmic accounts. These worldly interactions arise based on our very own karmic accounts of merit and demerit karma. No one has sent these to us. Whereas we see, he did it, she did it. But no, it is Vyavasthit. So if we bring about a solution by doing analysis with Jnan, and what more is there? There are expectations. I should get better. I should have it better than them. And like that, what does Dada say? Expect the worst. Play as though all the 6 coins you flip will turn on the wrong side. And if one of them turns the way you expected, then be happy. We weren't going to get anything. At least we got something. When these flights get delayed, one will say, oh, you came early. We left long ago, but Delta Airlines is like this. Instead, if we had taken a United flight, then there is comparison like this. And when we realize that they got us here safe and sound, then wouldn't we feel happy? Instead of getting into an accident trying to reach early, we reached late but in a safe and sound condition. So we feel happy, don't we? Yes, we reached safely. So let's be happy with that. Why be sad when reaching late? But they came early in that airline and we were late. Our time was wasted. So we should identify how we become unhappy and know how to stop them. In the slightest of unhappiness, we should find the positive aspects. Oh, they kept us safe at least. What is the problem? If the airlines feels the slightest risk, then they stop everything. And if they feel it's safe, then they allow the flight to take off. So we should feel happy. Instead, we start bickering. They made us late. They wasted our 3 hours. They didn't give us anything to eat. So this is what we want to achieve. See the positive side. Set the Jnan of Vyavasthit during comparison. And when will we do that penance? When will we do that penance in our life? When this intellect shows us negative things, that is when we need to do penance. When it is showing someone's fault, that is when we need to turn around by doing penance. No, that evidentiary doer is faultless. It is our Vyavasthit, based on our karmic accounts. One has to experience his very own karmic accounts. No one can escape from that. If you want to compare, then why not do it this way? He has gone to the toilet 3 times. Why did I only go once? I'll also go 3 times. No, his would be in accordance with his discharge, and ours would be in accordance with our discharge. Who can be blamed? And based on what was eaten, and based on the person's health, it gives results. So it was charged in the past life. The result comes to us on the basis of past life's karma. So what is the need to compare? But this happens while getting married as well. Look, he got a good match and I didn't. Earlier, another lady was the prospective bride, but then it turned out to be someone else. Back in the old days, this used to happen a lot. The prospective bride would be changed. Then there would be quarrels. I have seen such cases. But for us, these matters of comparison in satsang obstruct us. with regards to this satsang of ours, truly it is neither worth doing comparison in the work of seva nor in any other things. For us, the nyan that we are getting, the nyani, the one who has never been seen and will never be seen again in the future, this nyan of his, and how much time do we have left in this life? We need to get our spiritual work done. Without getting into any interference, any negativity, any comparison, we need to get our real spiritual work done. So, do this comparison or competition in the real. Actually, there won't be any competition in that. And in the relative, the comparison won't stop from happening. But in the real, it doesn't exist. So, it happened naturally with me. There was just one goal. What is the self? How is it? How to... That would go on day and night. So I've never felt good or bad in these matters. I did less work of Dada Seva. I didn't get any Seva. Someone else got it. I didn't have any kind of sorrow. I had much bigger work left to do. And later, Dada showered so much grace on me with his satsangs. Anytime he would tell me, come forward, ask something. Dada would give me special satsangs. And I got a lot of special guidance from Dada regarding the self. I got his blessings, and I kept getting keys of Nyan. Dada gave me a huge lift. So this is the thing that we need to hold on to, that this comparison, competition, jealousy, we should come out of all of these, and it is worth going towards the self. How can we... And I know this much, that while doing Dada's work, I would hardly get half an hour of satsang. I would sit right at the back, because the entire crowd would have sat at the front. Even if I could pick up a word, if I could get one sentence, then I could progress 500 steps in Nyan. Then I would get another sentence in a couple of days. It would feel like the best point. I would feel so fortunate because the satsang that was essential for me, I would get the keys which I was lacking in every satsang, in every couple of satsangs, and I would keep getting the links to be able to see the self, to experience it, to come out from the faults and to go towards the self. So it never felt inadequate. And then Dada would take special care of me. Niruma would take special care of me. This is because from the beginning, I never got into any interference in the relative. It was only about doing the spiritual efforts towards the real. So if we just hold on to this very thing, that let's focus only on the real spiritual efforts, let go of the relative, finish whatever you come across, be it at any time, clear the files with equanimity, finish the karmic accounts, let the circumstance go by clearing it with equanimity. Then there won't be any comparison. Because we have entered into the relative, there is unhappiness arising out of comparison. And that unhappiness is endless. It is never going to end. Then why don't we initiate spiritual effort towards the real? And that spiritual effort of the real is so vast that it won't end until Keval Nyan or absolute knowledge. What a big task we have left to do. And due to such small things, based on trivial matters, we see the soul at fault. There is God within every Mahatma. There is a pure soul within the coordinator, isn't there? And the coordinators are not the doers themselves. It is based upon Vyavasthit. And they give us work based on our karmic account. There was a very high-profile manager in Ahmedabad. He had probably come for the first time. And a Mahatma was told, hey, can you give him some seva? So he replied, yes, this spot is vacant. The shoes need to be looked after. That person was such a high-profile manager, he was considered a prominent officer in the government. So the Mahatma told him, do one thing, stand near the stairway of the temple. People will give their footwear, put them in a plastic bag, and hang them here. When they come back, return it to them. That was the first seva he was given. That poor guy panicked. I'm such a prominent person, and for me, this? He couldn't say it. He stood there. He did seva for 2 hours and then he stopped coming. Our reputation is tarnished. Gradually, he understood that this has in fact broken my ego. What a big favor has been done to me. He took it positively. Today, he's giving a lot of seva in our satsangs. He was quite a well-known officer in the government, but this is the very first seva he got. And we would be like, are you free? Here, get involved in this. Who knows who he is? We have so many Mahatmas. We don't know where each one comes from and what their position at work is. But that person still took it positively. Otherwise, he would have disconnected from satsang. So that is what happens. Why? It happened due to Vyavasthit, scientific circumstantial evidences. And Vyavasthita actually sends those evidentiary instruments to cure our own inner disease. If we take it so positively, then we have seen during pilgrimages that the ones who are fussy would get the worst rooms. The window glass would be broken, the lock of the bathroom's door wouldn't be working, the water would be leaking, the bucket would be broken. The one who is fussy gets the worst of things. And then he would get really upset and quarrel with the coordinators. He would break the horns of the ego of the coordinators. I told them, "Be happy. Who else will break our horns? We don't have a mother-in-law or a wife. We all do seva. So these people will break the horns of our ego. Consider it as a favor." In this way, after many years, their stock of karma also gradually emptied out. And from the time their interferences stopped, they started getting good things. We get defective things for our karmic accounts to get finished. Whereas we say, "People got it better, I got it so bad," and like that. Actually, if we do penance once, if we accept the substandard things, be it for 5 or 10 times, but once those end, then the opportunity to receive better things opens up. What happens in our case is that we push away the substandard things, so all the 10 still remain pending. In this way, we never finish those 10 in our entire life. In fact, we should act wisely. "Oh, why did I get this?" And this was Dada's principle. Each evidence, if something happened, he would study it in so much detail. Why did it happen? How did it happen? He used to say, "Once we stepped out of Mamanipur wearing a nice long coat to attend someone's wedding. We were wearing brand new clothes, and then someone from above, who was chewing betel leaves, spit on me, and there were stains on my clothes. So I looked up. That fellow ran inside." Then Dada thought, "If it had happened a second earlier, it would have fallen in front of me. If it had happened a second later, it would have fallen behind me. But it fell on me. On what basis? Who brought us two together? Why did I come to this particular location? He spit, and it fell on me." He said, "In doing so, the knowledge of Vyavasthita manifested in us. So many evidences and circumstances came to notice that we realize that this is based on scientific circumstantial evidences. It is not dependent on any one thing. So by continuing to study in this way," he said, "we were just like you, but we would never see anyone at fault in any incident. We would analyze and conclude who the doer is. And ultimately, by discovering many evidences, when the knowledge manifested in him, the entire science was revealed. So when any incident happens, why did this happen? Why did I get the seva of looking after the footwear? I heard recently that at the Gurudwaras, what they do is, when prominent people come, the first thing we tell them is, you have to do this seva of looking after the footwear. If you lower your ego, then God's blessings will shower upon you. This is the first seva we give them. So I said, that is a good rule. So they say that to lower the ego. If you want to do seva of God, then look after the footwear first. So they give this seva to prominent people, and in fact, those people do it happily because they believe it is their guru's command. They do it. But for us, it is natural. These people have this arrangement in place, and they do it heartily. No, I want to dissolve the ego, lower it. I want to do God's seva. But for us, nature, Vyavasthita is such that whatever kind of ego is there, if one feels, "I am smart," then his smartness itself will take a blow. "I have expertise," then his expertise will take a blow. "I am intelligent," then his intelligence will take a blow. By such laws of nature, evidences keep coming together and they break our ego. And it is when a great deal of merit karma unfolds that this disease of the ego breaks. And in fact, at that time, when these unfavorable circumstances come together, it needs to be taken positively. "Oh, this disease has been broken. Be happy." But there, the intellect creates turmoil. "He got this, I got this." If we really look at it, it is highly beneficial for jnana. Adversity, or if we get inferior work or inferior seva, that adversity is really beneficial for jnana. Only then can we, otherwise we would be engrossed. If we had good things or favorable circumstances, we would become engrossed. Without jagriti or awakened awareness, we would become engrossed due to lack of jagriti. So when something we dislike comes our way, then suffering arises, And then if we set Nyan within, then so much strength increases that our inner garbage starts emptying out, and the strength of Nyan keeps increasing. So this is something that should be welcomed. If we get something that we dislike, or something inferior, then take the benefit of Nyan. And if this intellect shows something negative, oh, how much worse did I get compared to them? Then show it, how much better did I get compared to others? We have got that which the entire world hasn't. We are extremely fortunate. We get to stay in this environment. One should feel, I'll get such vibrations at least. I'm at least getting to do darshan a couple of times on my way. It is a lot compared to not getting anything. I got seva where I have to be far away, but I'm still in this group of mahatmas, in this environment. Like this, take it positively. I would keep taking it positively right till the end. Even if I would get something as small as a tiny particle, then I would be so happy that at least I got this much instead of getting nothing. And as those old obstacles came to an end, there were so many new things that I started to get. I got so much, to the extent that Dada would say, come forward, ask something. I really like talking to you. Dada would do it more and more. I wanted to stay the furthest, thinking, let everyone take the benefit. I would willingly stay behind. Dada would bypass everyone and call me first. It is now that all this can be understood. So really, if we let something go, then nature actually gets it to us. We don't incur any loss. If we have the intent that may people benefit, may everyone progress, may everyone get plenty, then ultimately we end up getting it. And if we think, no one should get it, I should get more, then we are the ones who get the most obstacles. This entire language of nature should be understood, the whole method of nature. The one who wants to progress will have to adopt this path. He should come out of all this competition, comparison, and become noble. He should set the keys of Nyan in such a way that he doesn't become a cause of obstruction for himself. So, we have such a science. Dada has given us this science based on his own experiences. So, we should fit this. Whenever something arises, then clear it by setting this Nyan. We need to bring resolutions for our own intellect. If suffering arises, then we should thoroughly contemplate, why did you find this inconvenient? Whether it takes 2 hours or 12 hours, but with our thorough contemplation, we need to clear our garbage. And we are not to see the evidentiary doer as the wrongdoer or hold him at fault. And if we don't manage to do that spiritual effort, then we'll keep getting a beating, and sooner or later we will have to come to this stage. And it is based on our inner disease that these circumstances come to us. It's not that someone is sending them to us. So we'll have to understand this. Whenever this comparison arises, we want to set, it is on the basis of unhappiness and suffering, and then by applying the keys of Nyan, we need to come into our own happiness, into the state that is free of agitation. Does everyone understand this? Something like this must have happened in our lives, right? It is indeed the case with everyone. Now, if the same people were made to sit in the front for all 8 days, then quarrels would start. So there are rotations. We have this many sessions, so arrange this many people so that others get a chance to sit at the front and we'll go to the back. These arrangements are made as much as possible. The coordinators are making many arrangements so that everyone gets it equally. Even then, our merit karma come to unfold and we get something inconvenient. And then, the unhappy one, the fussy one gets substandard things. It's like when we sit for a meal and all the 7 of us get rice. But we get such rice in our share that a grit comes under our tooth, which is already aching, and then there is shooting pain. Who would have told the grit to reach this fussy person? It finds the right place. Vyavasthit sends it. Who can be held at fault? Based on one such incident, Nyan should fit in forever. It is like this in every incident. We get circumstances based on our vyavasthit. There is no fault of the doer or the sender. These evidentiary instruments are simply apparent doers. It is natural, because there is no God up there to send all these evidentiary instruments. So the one who has done an inner intent that I'll do this, and the one who has done an inner intent that I want this, then the two of them come together based on demand and supply. Fundamentally, one has to suffer the effects based on his own causes. But our intellect creates unhappiness by doing comparison of good and bad. And really, there is no good or bad. It is in the form of a circumstance, and it has the nature to dissipate. No one should be hurt. That is the best thing to keep. Right or wrong, good or bad, if we get rid of all of that, and if we just keep the goal that no one should be hurt, then most of the things of the intellect would be solved. If there are any questions from anyone, then we'll take those. And if there are entanglements like these arising in our lives, then let's comprehend how to bring solutions with Jnan. Because this can give a lot of suffering. And it can give so much suffering that it will show faults all the way up to Dada. It can even turn us away from this satsang. When this Simandar city was being built, there were so many complications due to this. There was no one with Niruma. All of us were quite young, all young boys. Some were recently out of college, while some came after doing some business. We didn't have any expertise. We didn't really know anything. And everyone was given the responsibility of some work. Someone got the temple work, someone got construction work, and so on. And the quality was not being maintained in that. No one was really an expert. Now, during that period, people felt, these people got it better, those people got this, I got this. But if we really look at it, I think it was built in the year 2000. So I guess for about 6 years, they got the benefit of living with Niruma. Now, whether they got a poor apartment or there were water leakage problems, whatever it may have been, but they got such a huge benefit of being with the living nanny. If we consider that profit, then in comparison to that, nothing at all can be considered a loss. But someone will say, they got this cheap, ours was expensive, they got better, they got it at the front, we got it at the back. So due to this intellect, the most important things to experience take a back seat. And we incur a huge loss in the unhappiness about these small trivial things. And Vyavasthit can't be changed even after quarreling. We get this only based on our karmic accounts. Everyone would have worked with the intention of creating the best of the best. Still, we get something defective. And I have also seen it here, in the houses here. We go to different houses, don't we? If you hear the problems, they're not any less here, be it about contractors or construction. There are many different problems. Problems are indeed prevalent. I have seen it in London and everywhere else. All the work gets disrupted due to contractors. In the dealings between owners and contractors, such problems have arisen that the entire work of motels has been adversely affected. So this, why would this happen? Based on our own karmic accounts, we come across things, these contractors, construction, a house to live in, and everything like that. It isn't based on the one constructing it or doing it, but it is based on one's own karmic account. So if we set such Jnan, only then we can get closure and inner satisfaction. Otherwise, there will be unhappiness and miseries and a lot of suffering. But if we keep the goal that this suffering won't unravel without Jnan, only then will it occur to us to find solutions with Jnan.